Graph each inequality on your own paper, then drag the inequality to match the correct graph. Well, I'm just going to show you how to graph each one of these inequalities, and then as far as the matching, you can do that yourself. Notice all these inequalities are in standard form or intercept form, so we're going to use that method. So what you do is you graph the line that's given right here. You have to imagine this is an equal sign for a bit, and then you shade either above or below that line. So for the first one, 3x minus 5y equals 15, we'll start by graphing that line right there. And remember, what you do for intercept method is you do 3x equals 15 and divide by 3 to get x equals 5. So you put a dot on x equals 5. Then to get the y, negative 5y equals 15, divide by negative 5, you get y equals negative 3. And then you put a dot at negative 3. Now let's look back at the inequality here for a minute. Notice that you have the less than with not equal to. That means you're actually going to have a dashed line here. So when you draw your line, make sure you dash it. And then it's going to be dashed this way also. So now we're going to do a test point to determine whether to shade above the line or below the line. Now the idea of a test point is you pick a point. I like to pick 0, 0 because it's easy to work with. And so you put that point in the inequality. And the idea is if this one point in this half plane is a solution, then all the points that are in this half have to be solutions. And if this point is not a solution, then none of these points are solutions, and you would have the other side as the solutions. So we go ahead and substitute. Put in a 0 for x, 0 for y. And so you're going to have 3 times 0 minus 5 times 0. So you're going to have 0 is less than 15. See how easy? And this is true. 0 is less than 15, which means all of these points on this side with the 0, 0 all make it true. And you shade the true side. So you shade all of this right here. This whole thing gets shaded. And you know what, if you have pencils, especially colored pencils, you can make really pretty graphs here. But this is all going to get shaded in. Okay, so that's the graph for the first one. Okay, for the second inequality, it's the same process. We're going to do negative 3x plus 5y equals 15. We're going to graph that one, and again, notice that you're going to have a dashed line here because there's no equal to. Let's do negative 3x equals 15 to find the x-intercept, divide by negative 3. Divide by negative 3, so x equals negative 5. So now put a point, x equals negative 5, right there. Now for the y-intercept, we're going to do 5y equals 15, divide by 5, so y equals 3. I'm going to point 1, 2, 3. And again, dashed line. Okay, something like that. Now the test point to see if we need to shade above or below. Substitute in a 0 for x, 0 for y. And so we're going to get 0 greater than 15. Now that is not true. So what that means is this point here with 0, 0 and all the other points down here in this half plane are not solutions. So the solutions are up here. And that's the part we shade in. Okay, so you go ahead and shade this in real good. And again, it's much easier to use a pencil. Looks a lot nicer. Okay, and don't forget to shade close to the line here. All right. So that's this graph of negative 3x plus 5y is greater than 15. Okay, the next inequality is 3x plus 5y is less than negative 15. So we're going to graph 3x plus 5y equals negative 15. And again, we're going to use a dashed line because there's no equal to here. So 3x equals negative 15 to find the x-intercept, divide by 3. X equals negative 5. So negative 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 5y equals negative 15, divide by 5. Y equals negative 3. There. And then we're going to do a dashed line. Okay, sort of like that. Test point, 0, 0. 0 for x, 0 for y. Going to get 0 is less than negative 15. That is not true. That's false. Which means that all the points up here with 0, 0 are not solutions. So the solutions are down here on the other side of the half plane. So you would shade this side right here. And shade all this in. Okay, so there's the graph for 3x plus 5y is less than negative 15. And the fourth one, 3x plus 5y is greater than 15. So we're going to graph 3x plus 5y equals 15, and we're going to use the dashed line and then shade either above or below. Solve for the x-intercept, 3x equals 15, divide by 3. So x equals 5. I'm going to put a point on x equals 5 for the x-intercept. And then for the y, 5y equals 15, divide by 5, y equals 3. So I'm going to point on y equals 3. And this one's going to be dashed also. That way. That way. So we're going to do 0, 0 again. So 0, 0, greater than 15. Is 0 greater than 15? The answer is no. So that means none of these points are solutions. The solutions are all up here. So this is the part that you shade in. All right, so that is the graph of the inequality of 3x plus 5y is greater than 15.